So one of the things you can do is, you know, change your diet, you know, to stay healthy. Diet has a big impact on it. One of the quotes that you gave us last year for the Quest was, you know, I said, how much education did you get in medical school on nutrition? You said, right. Pretty much none.
Pretty much none. You know, let's expound upon that. I don't know how it is now. You would hope that it would be better, but I'm not so sure that it is. And this all goes back to, I think, something you did talk about in one of the episodes,
which
was the Flexner Report, mm-hmm. and basically how corporate America, once again, intervened, limited people's choice, controlled the narrative, and basically influenced on what kind of medical education the doctors get. But the current medical education, and I went to one of the best medical schools in the country, Baylor College of Medicine. It's an outstanding school, but this is what they taught. And you know, we spent an inordinate amount of time in basic science. There's a basic science and there's clinicals. The basic science is the first portion of medical school where you learn science. You learn out of a book, basically sit in a classroom. And we went on and on and on about all kinds of different pharmaceutical drugs. We did have a nutrition course, and basically, here's vitamin D, and here's the molecule, and here's the mechanism of vitamin D, and here's how someone gets rickets, that kind of thing. But not here's how to eat, or you should tell your patients to eat this way, or mm-hmm. eat naturally, or synthetic vitamins versus natural vitamins, or anything along those lines. And it was literally a few days, maybe, you know, that we cover that kind of stuff. I mean, certainly vitamin D might come up a couple times again, but we're talking about the molecule and metabolism, and that's important information. But that's not learning nutrition, and that's not learning practically how to educate someone. You know, just like they don't teach doctors a thing about business, you know, and then they ultimately come out, and a lot of them suffer for that reason, you know, trying to run their own business. And so, you know, who knows? Maybe that's by design as well. But, anyway, different topic. But certainly the education that we get concerning nutrition is non-existent. It was non-existent. Pretty much none is probably an overstatement.
Pretty much not.
Yeah, pretty much not. Yeah. It's too much. Yeah, because I didn't really understand practical nutrition, mm-hmm. if you will, until well after med school, until after being in practice.
So you learned it after school.
Sure.
After you got out of medical school.
Which is very normal as a doctor. There's a lot of surgical procedures that I've learned because, mm-hmm. I mean, we don't go back to residency every time a new procedure comes out.
Sure.
You know, we have to be able to re-educate ourselves. But the person has to be willing to endeavor in that re-education. And so, you know, I told you the story. We'll talk about it again. When I was in the midst of losing weight, I was juicing, and, you know, so many different ways to do it, and there's so many different healthy ways to do it. I chose intermittent fasting, and I chose juicing, and I was going green and raw and trying to stay away from processed foods and so forth. And I ran into a doctor in the doctor's lounge at a hospital here locally, and we talked about this, and I said, hey, you know, if you lose weight, you get off diet, you know, just sort of talked about the benefits. This goes, well, why would you do that? He goes, I'm just going to eat my cheese nachos and take my cholesterol medicine, you know. And, you know, I don't know if he's messing with me a little bit, probably, you know, kind of sent me through the roof. I was like, really? You know, oh, and by the way, if we did that, you know, we wouldn't have a job. And again, probably messing with me to some degree. But I mean, this is how these guys think. Mm-hmm. And I can tell you right now that if every doctor thought more like me and really pushed, well, let's not say it that way. If every doctor really pushed nutrition, really, really generally pushed nutrition, it would be generations, it would be never really, before all of us would be out of a job. There's always going to be a job. There's going to be a use for pharmaceutical medications. I'm not anti-pharmaceutical medication. I'm anti-crutch. Some people use drugs as a crutch and then make zero effort to improve their health and take personal responsibility for their health.
Hi, this is Ty Bollinger. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video that you just saw, click the link below to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and we will provide you with the most up-to-date information from nutritional experts all over the world to help you stay healthy.